Hello everyone, welcome to Tong's Real World Data. This is Tong Wang. In this video, I will show you how to merge multiple data files in R. If your data is a pretest post-test design or a longitudinal design, you probably will have multiple data files that include data collected at different time points. A key variable will be used to link the data across different time points. Normally, it will be the ID number. My sample data is from a pretest post-test design. Classroom learning climate was assessed at the beginning and the end of the semester. To investigate whether learning climate changes significantly across a semester, I need to combine the pre- and post-data. In this case, my pre-data contains 36 observations, and my post data contains 78 observations. My key variable is ID. In the end, I would like to have a file containing both pre and post data, and matched by ID number. Now, I will show you how I get this done in R. First, let's import the data. My pre and post data was saved in two Excel files. We need to use the read Excel function to import the data. Please refer to my previous video, how to import your data in R, if you are not sure how to do it. I name my pre-data as pre-LC and post-data as post-LC. Let's check dimensions of the data to ensure that our data was imported correctly. So my pre-data includes 36 rows and 7 columns, and my post-data includes 78 rows and 7 columns. Before we merge the two data files, we need to rename each file to make sure all the variable names are unique, except for the key variable. Okay, first let's check the current column names in pre- and post-data. Both pre- and post-data include 7 variables, and the variable names are exactly the same. There is an ID variable and 6 variables assessing students' perceptions of learning climate. If we combine the two data sets like this, it will cause problems because we won't know which variables are from pre-data and which variables are from post-data. Therefore, we need to rename the variables and give each variable a unique name before we merge the two data files. And we use the rename function from the dplyr package. If you would like to know the details of renaming variables, please refer to my previous video, Renaming Multiple Variables in R. And here I assign the rename the data to pre-lc.renamed and assign the renamed post data to post-lc.renamed. Okay, now let's check the column the names of the renamed data. There is one common variable, ID, that's my key variable. And all the remaining variables have unique names. Therefore, when we combine these two data files, it's very easy to identify which variables are from pre-data and which variables are from post-data. Now we are ready to merge the files. There are 4 types of merging, namely cross-join, left-join, right-join, and full-join. If you only want to keep the cases with both pre- and post-data, you choose cross-join. If you feel your post-data is more important to your research questions, and you may want to investigate the relationships between post-data and other variables, then you can choose the right-join. So you keep all post-data, and all the cases with only pre-data will be deleted. You can also use a full-join to keep all cases. Let's go back to our RStudio. Let's do cross-join first. I assign the result of the cross-join to pre-post data. And I use the merge function to specify the data I want to merge, which are pre-LC renamed and post-LC renamed. And in R, we use the keyword all to specify the types of merging. And here, all equals false, indicating that I'm doing a cross-join. By checking the dimension of the pre-post data, we found that there were 24 observations having both pre and post data. Now let's do a left join, meaning I want to keep all the pre data. And I assign the result of the left join to all pre data. And let's copy the code from the cross join and made some modifications to the keyword all. Here, I change it to all.x, indicating that I want to keep all the cases from my x file. And to make it more clear, I assign the pre-data as the x file and the post-data as the y file. Let's check the dimension of the all pre-data. It has 24 rows. It seems there's something wrong with the code. Okay, it should be all.x equals true, not false. Okay, now it looks right. The all pre data includes 36 observations, which is consistent with our original pre data file. Now let's try to merge our data using a right join. We can copy the code from previous one and modify the keyword all. Change it from all.x equals true to all.y equals true. And check dimension of the all post data. It includes 78 observations, which looks right. Last but not least, let's do a full join. Similarly, we modify the code by changing the all.y equals true to all equals true, suggesting that we want to keep all the cases from both pre-data and post-data, and we assign this dataset to all data. By checking the dimension of all data, we can see that it includes 90 observations. Now we have successfully merged my pre and post data files. And in this case, I'm going to choose the all data as my final data. Sometimes you may want to share your data with your co-authors, and they may not use R for data analysis. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to write your R data as an Excel file. And you need to install a package called WriteXL and load the package. And you use the write_xlsx function to save the data. Since I already set up my working directory, here I only need to specify the name of my Excel file. And as usual, you can find all my R codes in the lecture note. In the next video, I'm going to show you how to do data screening in R. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.